you so much. Thanks, everybody. Hey. How the hell are you? Welcome, welcome, welcome. It's so good to be back here. It's so good to be back at Daryl's house. And I'm just very grateful that everybody came out to see me tonight. Thank you so much. If you haven't already figured it out, this is an evening of Utopia music. It's a band that I used to be in a while back. And I'm very proud of the work that I did in that band. And so I figured I'd put these shows together because we don't do enough Utopia music during a regular year. So this is my little gift to you guys for being so helpful and supportive for me and my career over the years. And without further ado, let's do another Utopia song. Hey, I got an idea. How about a Utopia song?
Here we go.
I grew up on Staten Island. Staten Island, New York. It's the southernmost part. What? Wagner College. Yeah, my daughter went to Wagner College. Of course, we have fucking fortune. Yeah. But she made the dean's list every year. Anyway, that's besides the point. I don't have to talk about my kids. I grew up on Staten Island. Anybody knows anything about Staten Island knows it's neither here nor there. It's not really, it's considered part of New York City, but it really is a place of its own. It's like this really weird, weird place. So as a kid growing up, I never learned to dance because, well, I didn't. I didn't. It's not like I came from Philly or even Brooklyn, or even though I was born in Brooklyn, I wasn't raised there. So I never really learned how to get my groove on, you know. And so some of these songs that I play, like especially like if you've ever seen Mr. Rundgren, he does these little two steps. I can't do a two step. I can't. And I watch these TikTok videos and I see how these kids do it one step at a time and then they put it all together and it's like, wow, that's amazing. I bet you I can do that. No, you can't. No, I'm sorry. You were raised in Staten Island. You're not gonna dance. You will never be a dancer. So what I want from you guys is just imagine if I was a really good dancer in this next song. And I was up here dancing that little freaking two-step that Todd does all the time. And then you could just, like, enjoy it. Okay, here we go.
Look.
bananas. Thank you so much. These are gorgeous. They're my colors. They're my colors? Oh, okay. Oh, thank you so much. This is beautiful. This is going right in my home, in my house. Thank you, Janice. Thank you very much. I love, this is why I do what I do, to get gifts. I don't know where to, I'm gonna give it to Susie, okay? A second. Susie will hold on to it. So I just got back a couple weeks ago. We've been doing this now. We're doing these shows for about, a week and a half, something like that. Something about that, maybe a week. But just before that, I was on a cruise. I was on the Rock and Romance cruise. Oh boy, was that a lot of fun. I'll tell you what. The only thing I was worried about was getting off the boat. But I have to say that I will be going next year. I already bought my tickets. I am going as a fan, as an audience member. I'm going on the Rock and Romance cruise next year. Because the advertiser saw this advertisement, and one of the bands that is going to be on the Rock and Romance cruise of 2021 is Toast. It's a tribute to bread. I swear to you, it's the God's honest truth.
I saw it.
So I guess if you're a fan of that band, you would be toasted, right? But yeah, it was worth the $8,000 just to buy a ticket, just to know that I'm gonna see Toast. In any case, in the meantime, I have these shows, and I'm so glad to be doing these shows. I love doing this. This is really a complete treat for me. Thank you. And we're going to do a song that the only other time I did this song was last year here and a couple of other places. So we're doing it again. Here we go.
The whole world is your oyster.
Thank you. I just got to make a little technical adjustment here. Give me 2 seconds. Thank you, Randy. And we are good to go. Go ahead. Recorded records a lot after that pyramid record. The way we recorded our records was everybody would bring in a little snips and pieces and bits and pieces of music, and then we'd all kind of throw them in a pile and spend a couple of days, maybe 3, 4, 5 days, sorting them out and putting this with that one and that one with this one, and then what would happen is we'd wind up recording a bunch of stuff, maybe half the record, without any melody or lyric. Just the songs, just the basic tracks for the songs, might be a couple overdubs here and there. And then either one of us would go and you know, try to write melodies and lyrics, but nobody was as good at it as Todd. And so he would just, he had this composition notebook that you get in school, and he would just sit there and, you know, 20 minutes later, write "Love Is the Answer" to a basic track. It's pretty fascinating. And so he wrote the lyrics to this song, and It was a little piece of music that I brought into the band, and then Todd wrote the lyrics, and we're gonna do it right now. It goes like this. Thank you. How's everybody doing? You hanging in there with me? Everybody's good? Everybody's having a good time? Everybody glad they came? Don't we what? It doesn't get better than this? Oh, yes, it does. It just doesn't get better than this right here, right now. I make you nervous? How am I making you? You mean you make me crazy? That's what you mean. You know you make me nervous. That's what it should have been. That would have been great. One of the great things about this show is that I get to do songs that not only I sang, but that the other guys in the band sang. And I'm going to do a song that we did, Todd sang. So I'm going to sing a Todd song. I'm going to try my best to do Todd justice and sing a Todd song for you all. Yeah. And it's not the swing version of Hello, It's Me either. Or the With a Twist version of I Saw the Light. But not that I mind doing that stuff. I don't mind doing it at all. It's actually very relaxing. It's very soothing and calming. But he's just so bored doing those songs, he's got to do them a different way here and there. Anyway, here we go. you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. This April marks marks 44 years since I was in the band. Jesus Christ, that sounds like a long time. I joined the band in April of 1976, and I was still living at my parents' house. As a matter of fact, I was sharing a bedroom with my two brothers. I was in a bunk bed. I was on the bottom bunk of a bunk bed. Alexander was on the top, and Lance was over on the other side, snoring away. And after I auditioned for the band, the next day I got home from Woodstock, and the next morning the phone was ringing and ringing and ringing. And this is before answering machines, before touch tone phones, but still a dial phone. And phone kept ringing. Nobody was home. My parents were at work. My everybody else was at school. And I didn't want to answer the phone because I was in bed. And yeah, I didn't want to get up. I didn't want to get up. I still don't want to get up. But I didn't want to get up that particular day. Anyway, finally, the phone was just incessant. So I got up, I answered the phone. It was Roger Powell on the phone. He said, "Welcome to Utopia." And that was the start of a trip, I'll tell you what. Next thing you knew, I mean, I'd never been out of Staten Island. The only places that I've been were the Jersey Shore and the Adirondack Mountains. That's it. And that's only because the next door neighbors had houses there. And they would take us, they would feel bad for my parents because I didn't grow up, you know, with a lot of dough. So the next door neighbors would take us on vacation over the summer. In any case, point being, that all of a sudden I'm traveling the world, I'm playing at Nebworth Festival in front of 300,000 people. I'm 20 years old, and we're opening for Led Zeppelin. And it's just, it's amazing, and we're doing television shows, and we're flying in planes, and I'd never been on a plane before. So when we started rehearsing for those first few tours, Todd had just released Faithful, and part of the promo for that record was that Utopia went out and did some shows promoting the Faithful record, and we did like Love of the Common Man, Black and White, Do Ya, and a couple of other songs, and we did this one song that for whatever reason it's just how music works for human beings. It just, this particular song just spoke to me more than any other song that we were doing at that time. And so I decided to put it in the set, and I just hope I do it justice for you guys. And it's a beautiful, beautiful song. So we're gonna do it now. Here we go.
Somehow that seems so cold. Somehow it seems so cold.
Meaning of the verb to love. What does it
I do this song because it's been one of the fan favorites over the years, and it's one that Roger did, and I love Roger so much, so I do this song in honor of him, and I miss him. I miss working with him. He was one of the most brilliant musicians that I've ever worked with, and along with a couple of guys that that I played with in Hall & Oates, along with Daryl and John. T-Bone and Bobby Mayo are just, they were just one of, I learned more from those two guys than I could ever imagine. And so I do this song for Raj, and I hope you enjoy it, and here we go.
Dancing on
Thank you.
Don't fade it, don't
you, thank you, thank you. Thank you so much. I can't tell you how much I appreciate you guys coming out and supporting me and seeing me, and I really love it. I mean, I've been, this is like our sixth, or is it the sixth show? I think it's like the sixth show. And people have been, you know, people come from Scotland to see us, and people come from Sweden, and there was a guy in New York who came from France to see the show. I hope nobody comes from Italy, though. In any case, I want to introduce this fabulous band to you guys. So, as most of you know, Jesse's been ill. He's recovering. And I'm sure everybody here sends their heartfelt wishes to him for a speedy recovery. I know he's going to get better. It's just going to take a second because he got whacked with pneumonia and then he got the flu on top of that. So he's doing okay, but I had to do this, and I had to get somebody to come in, and this guy Bruce McDaniel on guitar, he came in and really just lit it up. Bruce McDaniel. Bruce. A few years ago, we were just about to do the formal Utopia, the official Utopia reunion, and unfortunately Ralph Schuckett had some health issues and had to bow out at the last minute. I like it. It's all this health stuff as we get a little old. So please take care of yourselves, okay? Only fist bumps and elbow bumps and stuff like that. And so we found this guy from Portland from Israel via Portland through Rebop, through Todd's son, Gil Asayas on keyboard. And of course, I'm a little tired of spending 5 minutes making a joke about Andy and how he does everything, but he really does. He fixes everything, he plays everything, he sings everything. He does. Andy Ascalise on drums. That's my band. And This is a really, really cool year for me. There's a lot of stuff going on. I just finished a record with my buddy Phil Thornley, who is one of the most brilliant songwriters that I've ever worked with. And it's all done. We're mixing, just putting the finishing touches on a bunch of stuff right now. And it's going to be released over the summer. And then I'll tour behind it early fall. Maybe I'll even come back here. I don't know. I just want to say I've been here every year for the last 3 or 4 years, and I can't tell you how much I appreciate Daryl South Park for having me here year in and year out, and you guys make it possible. So I really appreciate that. And we got a couple of other things going on. There's going to be not so much a contest, but we're going to solicit some people to sing on the record. This is going to be like three notes. But you have to sign a 15-page non-disclosure agreement before. And I always do a cover song on my solo records, at least one cover song, and we did this song on the record. Before I forget, we don't have merch with us tonight, but everything is available online. There's cards over at the desk that tell you where to go, and that makes a nice thing that you can put up on your refrigerator. If you have a little spot on your refrigerator, you can put it up there with a little magnet, and everything is good. I love you guys so much, and here we go.
wasted. And where is the It's our world. Yeah, yeah, one world. 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 One world, one world, one world. It's our world, one world, one world. Yeah, yeah, one world. It's our world. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Thank you very much, everyone. Thank you, thank you, thank you for a great, great, great night. Thank you so much. I hope you had a good time. I'll come out and say hi in a minute. Just let me catch my breath, and I'll come out and say hi to everybody.